you doing?
I need some stuff for Jamie.
What stuff?
Milk.
He's got milk.
And diapers. Okay, he ran out.
No, he didn't. What are you doing, Louise? You trying to get me killed?
Please, please, I need to go out for a while.
And I told you no. I need you here. I need you.
I hate you for doing this to us, Vinny. I swear to God, I hate you.
Good, Louise, real good. Now, you want to shut off the waterworks?
You had a date last night, Vinny. Oh. What happened?
I'm getting the money. I just don't have it yet.
Break his legs?
No, I'll get the money, Claude. I swear I'll have it tomorrow, man.
Vinny, let's be honest with ourselves. A little punk like you will never have 10 grand. Shouldn't have been at that crap table in the first place. So learn your lesson and take it like a man.
No, Claude, I can get it. The envelope, man. On the TV, check the envelope, you'll see.
The envelope. So this is how you're going to pay me back. You're going to use your kid. Vinny, I was feeling sorry for you. Now I'm not. So, tomorrow, you bring me the money, or you're dead.
Louise! Louise!
The Mountie. Have you guys seen the Mountie?
You have an appointment?
Where is he?
Try the coffee shop.
That, okay.
We're not talking about just a haircut here, Frazier. We're talking about a change in lifestyle.
There's something wrong with your life, right?
No, there's something wrong with my hair, and that reflects on my life. Your hair is who you are, Frazier. It makes a statement.
Oh, I see.
Coffee?
Please. What does it say?
What?
Your hair. What's it saying?
At the moment?
Yeah.
Well, let's see. It's straight and slicked back, so I guess it's got that mess with me and you're dead style. Good for the job. The contouring around the ears, that's unexpected. That says, watch out, this guy might be dangerous. And then the feathering around the back, well, that's a nod to the female demographic. So what's it saying? It's saying deadly and dangerous, but not afraid to cry.
Really? Well, what does my hair say?
Oh, that's not hair, Frazier, that's a pelt.
Oh.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you kindly.
You know, I just have this feeling that something's missing.
Pardon me. Oh, sir. It's to be expected, Ray. I mean, after all, as man ages.
Well, what are you saying? You're saying I'm thinning?
No, no, no. I'm not saying you're thinning. I'm
saying... You want to see thinning? I'm going to show you thinning. Hey there. You need a hand?
That's okay, sir.
It's gone, Frazier.
What's gone, Ray?
That thing, that je ne sais quoi.
It's just a bald spot, Ray.
Oh, 2 minutes ago I'm thinning, now it's a bald spot.
I'm sorry, Ray, but I thought you realized.
Where? Where, at the back? Is it bad? How bad? Frazier,
There's a baby in my car.
Yes, there is, Ray. There certainly is.
I mean, call me old-fashioned, but I think there's nothing as attractive as a man with baby formula on his sleeve.
Oh, please.
Well, could you, would you mind?
Anything else I can get you?
Well, yes, actually, if you could just,
Oh, sorry.
Thank you.
This is pathetic.
Oh. I know, but he seems to be enjoying it.
Not him, you! Okay, diaper changing time. Any volunteers? I didn't think so. Come on, let's dig us up a social worker.
Well, you think that's wise, Ray? I mean, the mother comes looking for him.
What mother? The kid was abandoned.
Well, not according to this. Look, blankets, cloth, diapers, extra clothing. The food is all homemade and in reusable jars. This mother cares about her child very much.
Oh, yeah, that's why she left him in the back of a parked car.
I don't think she planned to, Ray. I think she's desperate and she needs our help.
How do you know that?
I think she saw us in here but couldn't attract our attention. And she has to live nearby. She couldn't have run very far with all of this in her arms.
Oh, come on, Fraser, moot point. Procedure is you find an abandoned kid, you call a social worker and tag she's it. And then he goes to a holding center.
Is that like an orphanage?
No, it's a very modern facility where they hold a kid till they can place him in a foster home.
An orphanage?
No, it's not an orphanage.
What if the mother wants the child back?
Well, then there'll be an investigation. If it turns out there was extenuating circumstances, maybe.
I see.
Oh, come on, Fraser, don't give me that big-eyed Mountie. Look, it's police procedure. Now, give me the kid. Give me the kid.
Diefenbaker, no, you heard him. It's procedure. He has a philosophical objection, you understand.
So what, the wolf has a thing about family values?
Well, most wolves do. Surely you've heard stories of wolves raising children that were abandoned in the wilderness?
Those are not historical accounts, Fraser. Those are Disney movies.
Myth springs from truth, Ray. Most wolves form very strong loyalties and will kill to defend them. I know. I've experienced it.
Really?
Oh, it's all right. He knows you. Just keep your hands where you can see them. And make the puffin face.
I am not going to make the puffin face.
Make the puffin face.
I don't even know what a puffin is. Oh, you look ridiculous.
No, I don't.
Oh, yes, you do.
So, this is the...
It looks better on the inside.
Well, I'm sure it does.
Fraser, it's not a workhouse. They don't put kids on treadmills here.
No. Of course not. We'll be right back. They seem happy enough.
Hi, how are you?
Are you my daddy?
No, kid, I'm not.
Well fed, too.
You're my dad.
No. No, kid, I'm not, but I'm sure he'll be along soon enough, okay?
Oh, yes, very soon. Ray?
6 o'clock.
What?
You got till 6 o'clock to find the kid's mother. After that, he hits the treadmill.
Well, I thought you said that they didn't have
Never
any...
mind that. Come on, get in the car.
Thank you kindly.
How much did you get? 5 big ones. He's good. Real good.
Sure, she could be blonde or brunette.
Sorry. But cloth diapers, how do you prevent them from leaking?
Sphagnum moss. It's an old Inuit method. It's naturally antibacterial, holds 3 times its weight in liquid.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Benny, you want to save the survival tips for later?
Oh, of course, Ray. Just make sure that you check for bugs.
All right, that's 3 parks, 2 toy stores, and a mommy and me class. I think we've done our duty by the little tyke.
Uh-oh. Ray, would you mind? I think he's got gas.
Oh, come on, Frazier.
No, I changed him. Fair's fair.
Look, we are getting nowhere, okay? We need a better description than hair color, race, and possible matching dimples.
Oh, no! Frazier, give me something. Give me your rag.
No.
Give me a hat. Give me the hat.
Leave it.
Frazier, this is Armani.
It's interesting.
No, it's not interesting. It's vomit. There's interesting, and then there's vomit. Now get it off of me.
Hey, this isn't formula. It's curdled. I don't think it's cow's milk. The curdles are too small.
Well, who cares what it is? Just get me to a dry cleaner, will you?
Where's the nearest dairy mart?
Yep, it's vomit, all right.
Yes, but do you recognize the curds?
I don't know. It's a little chewed up.
Maybe if you let it harden.
On suede, what are you, a sadist?
Perhaps an educated guess.
Well, if it came out of the child's stomach, I'd say goat's milk. Smaller curd, easier on the tummy.
You have anybody who special orders?
Oh, yeah, a few. Yeah, some have allergies, some just buy it for their kids.
How many?
Naked baby on the ground. Sky above, I communicate this to you. My only thought is love. Yeah, still I got hands like starfish pushing it to the night. Makes no effort to conceive.
I think things have been kind of tough, you know, with me out of work and Louise worried about how we're going to take care of Jamie. I guess she just snapped. The doctor said she was just depressed after the baby. All she needed was a few weeks and she'd get over it, but...
Where is she now?
She's out looking for Jamie. I mean, we both were, right? But then I came back, you know, I thought maybe somebody would call.
No, I know. We ran into one another outside the coffee shop.
Yeah, so sorry about that. I was pretty freaked out. And Louise, she was even worse. I mean, she practically fell apart when she realized what she did. She's crazy about this kid. I mean, I never seen her cry like that, right? And I say to her, I say, it's okay. You just made a mistake. Well, you can understand a mistake, can't you, detective?
Do you have any identification?
The Mountie. Have you seen him anywhere?
Maybe. You his girlfriend?
No. Did he have a baby with him?
Oh, you got him babysitting for you, huh?
Please, can you just tell me if you've seen him?
Will you live on Hastings?
Yeah.
Then you better hurry. Babysitting. Why didn't I think of that?
All right, father's driver's license matches the baby's birth certificate. I'm happy.
Do you have any family photographs?
Benny, it's the kid's father. Everything matches up.
He kind of looked like Kermit the Frog at first, but that's him. Ain't it, little guy?
Stephen Baker, this is the baby's father. Well, thank you for your patience.
Really? You don't know what this means to Louise and me. We won't forget you.
Just don't leave the baby unattended again.
I don't know. You know, my mother never left me alone. And if she did, there was always somebody there to look after me.
Diefenbaker?
Oh, great. We got a jealous wolf now?
What is it?
Oh, come on. You already passed the sniff test. What more do you want?
Maybe I wasn't specific enough. Maybe I didn't ask the right questions.
Oh, what's he supposed to be? Some kind of lupine lie detector now?
The pacifier.
What?
He threw the baby's pacifier onto the ground. You take the front. Are you Louise?
Yes, yes, I gave you my baby, so, where is he?
His father,
Oh, my God. He's gonna sell him. He's gonna sell Jamie.
...1974 white Chevy convertible. Illinois plate, Robert John David 809. No, do not apprehend. He's got a kid with him. Just give me a location.
At first, I thought he was just letting off steam. He was out of work, nothing to do but stare at the four walls, so he would go out at night and bet a little. Lose, mostly. And he would pick up a day of work here and there, so I thought it was just a few bucks. Until his unemployment checks started to disappear.
How much did he lose?
He wouldn't tell me. But the man, the one who threatened him, he said $10,000.
Must have been some roll.
Yeah, well, if you ask me, I think they saw him coming.
And the baby?
It was so stupid. I thought he was just talking crazy like he does sometimes when things get bad, but I never thought that he would. There was this man who came by the neighborhood, and he said that he worked for this lawyer who specialized in helping people like us. People who couldn't take care of their kids. I told him to go to hell, but Vinny... All Vinny could see was how much he cost us. Doctor's bills, grocery money. I couldn't work, so of course that was Jamie's fault, too. And Vinny, he was just so angry all the time. He wouldn't even hold him. His own kid. He's not a bad guy. He didn't used to be.
We'll find him.
Look, if you want us to arrest him, you're gonna have to swear out a complaint.
Is that what you want?
They say that you believe in people. That you're the only one in the neighborhood without locks on his doors.
Yes, well, that's, it's not entirely intentional.
Someone stole him.
This attorney, do you remember his name?
Morisot and Associates, attorneys at law. Hold, please. Morisot and Associates, attorneys at law. How can I help you? She's in a meeting. Would you like to leave another message? Thank you.
Look, it's been 30 minutes now. Could I just go in and drop off what...
You got a chair?
Yeah.
You got a magazine?
Uh-huh, but I just want... You got a mouthpiece named Morisot here?
It all depends on what Flatfoot is asking.
No, Ray, this may not be the best.
I'll tell you what, Millie. You get Morisot out here, I hold a seminar on black market baby selling in your lobby.
Magazine.
Okay, how many of you folks are here to arrange for adoptions?
Ray, we have no evidence.
Frazier, look, this is how it works, okay? A sleazeball lawyer rents a fancy office, and poor suckers like these thinks he's legit. Next thing you know, he's buying and selling babies like rugs in the Casbah. Excuse me, ma'am, you know what could happen to a little tyke in a place like this?
We just came to use the restroom.
I'm Miss Morisot. Can I help you, detective?
Yeah, you can turn that baby over to me. I can slap a pair of handcuffs on you.
Perhaps you should step in.
Perhaps we should.
This will just take a minute. Now, just what the hell is this all about?
Miss Morisot, we have reason to believe that that child has been put up for adoption without the full knowledge and agreement of both of its parents.
Which makes you a fraud, a kidnapper, and not a very nice person.
Detective, I can't decide if you are naturally offensive or just naturally ignorant. In either case, it might behoove you to check your facts before shooting your mouth off.
How much did she offer you, Vinny? 40, 50 grand for that kid?
Can't you do something? Get him out of here.
I hate to burst your bubble, Detective, but this is a completely legal adoption. Any compensation the parents may or may not receive is fully allowable under Illinois law.
Oh, come on. Louise Weber doesn't even know her kid's being sold off.
Louise Weber sat at this table 6 weeks ago and signed these application papers in my presence. You will notice that they are witnessed, notarized, and the appropriate copies have been filed with the Illinois State Adoptions Board.
The mother knew?
Of course she knew. I'm a respected attorney constable, not some backstreet baby snatcher. I make my living from people who trust me and make referrals. That should be obvious.
I'm out of here. You deal with this.
You signed an agreement, Vinny.
I'll be there.
Oh, Vincent.
What?
Goat's milk.
What?
He drinks goat's milk. You're almost out.
Tell him, did you?
I thought that maybe they wouldn't help us.
Nobody is gonna help us. We're in too deep. That's why we gotta do this.
But Jamie, it was us too.
It'll be better for him. You should see these people, Louise. They got money, heaps of it. He's some big corporate guy. He's got his own plane. What are you and I gonna offer this kid except a whole lot of nothing?
You never tried, Vinny. Not once. You're just too busy thinking about yourself.
Yeah. It's always me. Everything's my fault. You signed those papers, Louise. Nobody put a gun to your
head. We both did something really stupid, but that doesn't mean that we can't change our minds. Look, the lawyer said...
Both of us have got to back out, not just you. I can't afford that. I back out, I'm dead.
Vinny, please. Think about what you're doing.
I got no choice, okay?
Fine. You...
He never listens.
I'll get the car. You know how hard it is to find goat's milk at a 7-Eleven if it wasn't for the Armenian at the cash register?
Thanks, Ray.
Breaking your heart over someone else's kid, it's not a smart move.
No, you're probably right.
You know what you're gonna say? You'll think of something.
Come on, get out of here! Get out of here! All right, I'm calling the pound. What the hell is wrong with you?
Let's turn the conversation away from dog pounds if I were you. Not surprisingly, he lacks perspective on the subject. May I?
What are you doing here?
Well, I got some things for your son. You might want to warm this up.
I got milk. Now, you want to get your wolf away from my kid?
Oh, well, that's going to be difficult.
Why, is he nuts or something?
No. It's just, he rarely does anything I ask him. We've tried to work through it. God knows I have done my part, but it's something we can't seem to get past.
This is nuts, man.
I know. It's a conundrum. But he does seem intent on staying, so if I were to hazard a guess, I would say that he must have a reason.
The wolf.
Apparently. Mm. Did you do anything to make him think you need him?
Oh, come on, man. What do I need with the wolf?
Now that's an interesting question. According to the textbooks, a wolf is a hunter, an animal of prey. The Inuit take a very different view of it.
The Inuit?
The people of the North. They have their own idea of why the wolf was created. You interested? In the beginning, so goes the legend, there was a man and a woman. And nothing else on earth walked or swam or flew. And so the woman dug a big hole in the ground and she started fishing in it. And she pulled out all of the animals. The last animal she pulled out was the caribou.
Thought this was about wolves, man.
Well, they'll be along in a minute. And so the woman set the caribou free and ordered it to multiply. And soon the land was full of them. And the people lived well. They were happy. But the hunters... The hunters only killed those caribou that were big and strong. And soon all that was left were the weak and the sick. And the people began to starve. So the woman had to make magic again, and this time she called Amarak, spirit of the wolf, to winnow out the weak and the sick, so that the herd would once again be strong. The people realized that the caribou and the wolf were one. For although the caribou feeds the wolf, it is the wolf that keeps the caribou strong.
So what are you saying? The wolf's gonna eat me?
Perhaps.
Inuit story.
Yep.
Let's hope it works.
Get off me. Come on, get off me. Get off me. Get off me. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, okay. All right. It's okay. It's okay. Come on. Daddy's here. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. That's my boy. Okay. And you're gonna like it. When I was a kid, I always wanted to live in a big house with a backyard. And you know what? I bet you're even gonna have a tree house. Things can't always be the way you want them to. Well, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. You better learn that. You kid yourself sometimes. But when you do, it catches up to you. So don't say your old man never taught you anything.
Lift, Vinny?
Easy, man. What? Watch your kid.
You're gonna kill him.
No, no. They'll get their money first.
There's nothing we can do or say to change the way that all things are, except to wonder from afar and contemplate the things we see. We're worlds away now, you and me.
We can talk about Montana, we can talk about the moon, we can talk about each other, we can fly away to Neptune. We'll never have to leave, we'll never have to leave, we'll never have to leave.
So we're just gonna sit this one out?
Well, you can't solve people's problems for them, right?
Well, at least he'll have a new home and new parents. He's probably better off.
The tongue is waiting for the talk. The secret is the thing will be. We're worlds away now.
So now he changes his mind with guns and criminals?
Shoot him, please.
In the back?
Unless you can think of a better angle. Yes.
Seconds, now what?
You take the big one, I'll take the bigger one.
Frazier, there's three of them. Can't I just shoot them?
Not unless you want to blow up 32 tons of jet fuel.
You are. Even the lowest creature is blessed with a survival instinct. Come on, Vinny, give me the kid.
No way, man. You want to take now? Go ahead, but you're not getting my kid.
It's your choice.
Are you gonna call him off?
Diefenbaker,
off. He never listens.
It's true.
Let's go home.
You take our kid. You scare the hell out of me. You got a lot to make up for, man. Thank you.
You're welcome.
She's a little upset.
Please, let me talk about this.
I think she was nearsighted.
Who?
Chick with the bike.
Oh, you mean at the coffee shop?
Yeah.
Well, she was probably too young for you, right?
Oh, no, it's not her. It's just that she didn't notice my je ne sais quoi.
From the French meaning, I don't know what?
Yeah.
Have you ever considered that maybe you've just replaced it with something else?
Really? What?
Yeah, that's it.
What?
I'd rather not say.
Come on, Frazier.
No, Ray, it's your hair. You wouldn't be right.
Well, no, we're partners, man. You gotta be brutally honest with me.
All right. In one phrase?
Yeah.
Je ne sais quoi.
Sky will carry you away. You know you have to leave here. You wish that you could stay. It's four directions on this map, but you're only going one way. Due south.